It's day four of the swimming competition of the Chengdu 2021 FISU World University Games as we welcome you to the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Aquatic Centre for the medals session. We begin day four, the medals session with the women's 1,500 metre freestyle final. The roar is for the favourite, the World Aquatics Championships medalist over this event. She's gone 15:45. She did that a week ago in claiming bronze at the World Aquatics Championships. Li Bengjie goes in four. Von Rensburg, Ebina, Cesarano, Li, Holub, Kajimoto, Ramatelli, Kalandadze. This is the women's 1,500 metre freestyle final, and getting off to an imperious start already is Li Bingqiu, 21-year-old Chinese superstar in the pool, and we'll see what kind of time she's looking to take it out in. Li Bingqiu took a bronze medal behind Katie Ledecky, and Simona Quadrello holds the FISU record of 15:57.90. She swam 15:45 at the World Aquatics Championships last week to take that bronze. She should go out in under 30 seconds, and she does, 29:45. Li ahead of Kajimoto with Cesarano of Italy within striking distance as well, but she's already edged out into a decent lead. And what you'll expect to see is swimmers trying to find a pace early on, but it's important not to let the pace or the actions of those around you affect your race plan unless you recognize it's a now or never situation, and that's usually a little later in the race. The very best swimmers, though, don't feel the pressure to go with other swimmers who might take it out harder in the opening part of the race. Instead, they stick doggedly to their plans, swim their own race. Half a second off the pace of Li is Cesarano at the 100 mark. Kajimoto of Italy tucked into third. Cesarano is fading a little in terms of times, which means Holub is coming into her own. She's swimming consistently in lane three. And Cesarano is now nearly 2 seconds down on Li, but Holub, importantly, the Portuguese swimmer, is within a second of Cesarano. Li Bingqiu coming up toward the 1,200 meter mark. 13:02.21. Cesarano, 4:20 back. Holub over 6 seconds back, but Holub is just being reeled in by Kajimoto now, but the focus still very much on Li. She is not allowing herself to be caught at second place in the last 100, but taking the bell is Li, significantly in front. It's been a dominant performance in this race. She started by taking the race out in under 30 seconds and then settled into a very fine tempo of under 33 seconds. Li Bingqiu, she's got the ability to have that burst at the end and switch from that aerobic system to the anaerobic system. After swimming, there's even splits throughout the race. Watch the battle for second, though. Kajimoto has upped the tempo. Cesarano has tried to up the tempo as well, but Li makes the turn with under 15 minutes, meters to go. The battle for second is an enthralling one. Cesarano has been caught by Kajimoto, who first had to reel in Holub of Portugal and now is reeling in the Italian. Can Cesarano hold on in second spot? The FISU record is safe. Simona Quadrella's record will not be broken by Li Bingqiu in the pool. But Li Bingqiu, with a dominant performance, powers her way to the wall. Outside of record time, but guaranteeing gold. Watch the silver. It's going to go to Japan. What a swim from Kajimoto in the closing 200. Cesarano of Italy medals. She's on the podium. Holub of Portugal will come home fourth. But she faded dramatically in the closing stages of this race. The champion, Li Bingqiu. What a swim. Her third gold medal of these games, but her first individual. Bronze goes to Naomi Cesarano, who claims her third medal of these games. Kajimoto Ichika of Japan takes silver, but gold, her third at Chengdu 2021, to Li Bingqiu, to the final of the women's 200-meter individual medley. From Hungary's Széchenyi István University, it's Dalma Sebastian, the 26-year-old, who goes in four. Knop, Matsumoto, Thiel, Sebastian, Ishihara, Gastaldi, Pirovano, and Von Berkom. Away they go in the women's 200-meter individual medley final, a sprint in all four strokes. So this is going to be the opening fly leg, then into back, then breaststroke, then free. It's so key to have higher tempo in the 200 meter IM than you do in the 400 IM. At the moment, the fly being led out by Castaldi of Italy, going well in lane six. She's got a great fly and a good backstroke. If she can set herself up for a really decent back end after a positive front end, she could get herself into a position to challenge for the gold medal here. But Sebastian looks to be controlling her race nicely as well. But Castaldi and Pirovano, both Italians, leading or in the front three after the opening 50 meters into the backstroke leg here. The back and breaststroke legs, the middle section effectively, is where most often you see athletes take the lead or fall off the pace. We're back and free though. The swimmers tend to suggest the 200 IM is more leg dominated, while in the 400 IM it's more arm dominated. Castaldi leads. Matsumoto and Ishihara now have snuck up into second and third into the breaststroke leg. Oh, this is where a few swimmers will come into their own. Sebastian and Thiel are quickest, but don't discount Matsumoto, a very fine breaststroker. Going well in lane six is Castaldi. Sebastian is coming into her own out of Szczecin István University. Watch the clock for her at the end. She'll be targeting that 2:11 mark. Sebastian, maybe just a little off that at the moment. Out in 49, in 140, 45 through 150. Castaldi ahead of Sebastian and Thiel, as we expected. Sebastian and Thiel coming back into it, courtesy of their fine breaststroke legs. Now Castaldi, has she got the energy? Has she got the ability to hold on in the closing stages? She set herself up beautifully for the victory after the very, very solid 100 to open with that fly and then into the backstroke. Castaldi is going strong, but she's being closed down by Sebastian, who might run out of space in the bull. It's going to be Castaldi of Italy who touches first ahead of Hungary's Sebastian. Thiel of USA manages to medal by finishing third. She's on the podium. That's a great result for Texas A&M University's Thiel, but an even better result for 20-year-old University of Pisa student Anita Castaldi. Castaldi the champion, 2:12.74, Sebastian 2:13.44, and medaling for USA, Carolyn Thiel, 2:14 she swims. Now to the final of the women's 100 meter backstroke. The star list, USA and Portugal represented, Japan, Italy and Poland each have two swimmers in the last eight of the women's 100 meter backstroke. The women's 100-meter backstroke final is underway. Getting off to a glorious start going in lane four is Piskorska, quickly into her stroke as she comes out of the underwater. Alongside her is Rodrigues Rebelo of Portugal going in lane five. Good reaction time from Pasquino set her up for a really quick start, but going nicely in lane eight is Paulina Pera, who's having a suboptimal championship by her incredibly high standards. Watch the time going out, though. It'll be interesting to see how quickly Piskorska goes out. 29 mid is where she'll be aiming. 29 low, 29.13. Piskorska ahead of Mostek. Pera is third. Poland currently in 1 and 3. At the turn, though, it looks a little better for Camila Rodriguez Rebelo. Back into the mix, the 200 meter backstroke silver medalist. Mostek is still very much in the mix as well for medals. The 19-year-old swimming for Harvard Crimson. Paulina Pera is starting to fall away and coming into her stroke now. Finishing strongly is Piskorska. Toma is looking to finish strong as well, but it's going to be a Polish victory as Piskorska comes home ahead of Rodriguez, with Toma of Italy third. Piskorska so quick out, 29.13. She doesn't break the 60-second mark, but she wins in 1.02 seconds. And it's the swimmers in lane 4, 5 and 6 who finish 1, 2 and 3. Piskorska, the champion, 1 minute, 0.20 seconds ahead of Rodriguez, with Toma third, as Italy medal again. This is the final of the men's 200-meter breaststroke. The world champion, the world record holder, from Tongji University, Qinhai Yang, the 24-year-old, goes in lane four for China. A week after setting a new world record in the men's 200-meter breaststroke on his way to claiming gold at the World Aquatics Championships, he swims in front of his home fans here. They adore him. Yu Wikiera, Fukasawa, Chin, Fusko, Sidlauskas, Hanagoruma and Zabojnik. getting away beautifully, and he'll use his underwater well, not quite all 15 meters, but in the breaststroke. Coming up in front is Chin Ha-young, the world record holder, who's looking to control the pace from the outset. So important that he gets off to a good start. His reaction time is quick, but not the quickest. That was Fukusawa off the starter's blocks. Yu going in one is looking to keep an intense pace in the opening 50, and trying to keep with Chin is Fusco, the Italian, and Fukasawa of Japan. Going in six nicely as well is Szyslauskas, who can be quick. He touches third, Fukasawa is second, but Chin has this race under control as he touches sub-29. If you're not touching sub-30 seconds, you are out of this race at the moment, and that means there are a couple of swimmers that are going to genuinely challenge for a medal. Among them is Hanaguruma Yu of Japan, going in seven. He looks to be well beyond his best here at Chengdu, and he seems to be struggling. But at the front, the man who is not struggling is Chin, whose world record saw him out in 28.53. He went 28.71. He then split 32.19, so he's slower than world record pace, but it's still quick. Chin Ha-young, Fukasawa, 0.35 of a second back, and Szyslauskas now a little slower over the second 50 meters. He's still in contention for a medal. Might he make a charge over the last 100 as well? Watch Fukasawa. He's biding his time. He's a 208 swimmer, and he knows how to pace himself, but I'm just a little concerned that he's trying to hang on to Chin here, and maybe that might burn him out. When he comes home for the final 50, may not have enough energy, but I hope his tactic is sound. He's looking to stay off the shoulder of Chin, who turns now with 50 meters to go. Within a second of him is Fukasawa, and now Hanaguruma has come back into his own. This will be a stupendous medal if he can come back in from the position he was in after the opening 50. Chin Ha-young is just powering his way now to the wall. He is in firm control of his own racing, and indeed of this race, with 15 minutes to go in one of the toughest races, oxygen deprived, with the amount of time that the head is underwater. A man who's paced his race to perfection, looks like he'll touch in FISU record time. It is a FISU record, 208.09. The champion is Chin Ha-young of China, ahead of the Japanese pair of Hanaguruma and indeed Fukasawa. A third gold medal in the pool for Chin Ha-young in FISU record time, 208.09. Hanaguruma with a grand recovery, second after the opening 50, touches second, and then bronze to Fukasawa of Japan. To the final of the men's 200-meter butterfly. Japan are the only country with two representatives in this final, and both swimmers are fast. But watch out, the top four swimmers in the top four lanes. So lanes 1 to 8 for the men's 200 fly final. Lamastra, Park, Wang, Chen, Terada, Terakado, Gemov, and Yaskiewicz. Great reaction time off the starter's blocks. Absolutely exploded off the starter's blocks to Chun-er, the only teenager in the final, in a stroke that takes you years to master. And he comes out nicely in control of this race and in front. Lamastra going strong for USA in lane one. So too the Polish swimmer Yaskiewicz going in eight. He looks to just be dipping off a little in the closing stages as he comes up to the wall at 50. How quickly is Chin taking this out, though? He touches over half a second ahead of Wang, with Terada in third. Now Terada needs to make sure that he can stick within a second of Chen. I would imagine if he is to genuinely challenge for the gold medal, that Chen would feel he is heavily favored for. The Wang of Chinese Taipei is going brilliantly. 155 swimmer at his best. He went 156.76 in the preliminaries. Great reaction time from Park as well, but he's been unable to maintain it. Coming back into his stroke now is Yaskiewicz of Poland, going in eight. He might touch second. He touches third, just behind Wang. But Chen of China is firmly in control of this race. It's a matter of tactics in this race, and you need to hope your tactics are spot on. Yaskiewicz looked like he's going for the stronger middle section in this race. Terada will be hoping for the stronger back end in this race. Chin liked to take it out hard, and indeed he set it up brilliantly. 25-24 over the first 50, 54-35. Look at his chin tucked in beautifully. Chin touches at the wall. Wang has come back at him in that 50, though. Terada is back in the mix. Off the wall, Wang is challenging Chin now for the gold medal. Wang is quick over this distance. He's a 155 second swimmer. He might go quick figure here. Chen Junhe is a 154 swimmer. Chen is looking to hold on, but he is fading fast. Coming in lane 5, Terada as well is coming back at Chen. Wang of Chinese Taipei looks like he's going to secure Chinese Taipei's first gold medal at Nepal at Chengdu. Is it going to be Japan? No, Terada is looking to close quickest. It's Terada of Japan just ahead of Wang. Chen finishes third in an incredible race. The men's 200-meter fly. Tactics a little awry. But what a scramble in the closing 50 meters. A tremendous victory for Terada Takumi of Japan. 155.66 from Nippon Sports Science University. Outside his personal best, but he takes gold. 155.66, 300ths of a second ahead of Wang of Chinese Taipei. And within half a second, Chen of China. Now to the men's 50 meter backstroke final. Simone Stefani, the 23-year-old from Pegaso Telematic University, goes in four and looks for a second individual gold medal. Now we're going to see a race that sees swimmers go sub at 25 seconds. Watch out for Italy in four and five. It's Bonan, Angel, Popescu, Stefani, Lamberti, De Arojo, Wang and Lin. Two Chinese swimmers going in 7 and 8. Italy eyeing a 1-2 in this men's 50-meter backstroke final. Lamberti and Stefani getting off to decent starts here, but there's very little separating the front four. Going very well in lane two is Angel of Romania, who looks to just be in front, 25 meters to go. Coming into his stroke now and looking really quick is Stefani. Lamberti alongside him, matching him stroke for stroke. Angel is still very much in the mix, and going in eight is Lin Tao. He looks like he might get into the medals, just misses out. It is Italy 1 and 3. Angel touches second and splits the Italians swimmers, but Simone Stefani has his second individual gold, and he's done the double 50 and 100 meter back gold. What a swim from the 23-year-old. Lamberti can celebrate a bronze. And I can tell you that Lin Tao wasn't too far off the mark, touched fourth, 25.19, to miss out on a medal. Italy go 1 and 3, Romania have another medal. It's Andre Angel with silver. Now for the women's 4x200-meter freestyle relay final. The youngsters, Yoshi Momoka, Matsumoto Shio, Nagao Kanon, and Kajimoto Ichika represent Japan, who go in four. People's Republic of China go in five with their A team. South Africa and USA will also battle for the medals. They go in 3 and 6. Singapore, Brazil, South Africa, Japan, China, America, Korea, and Switzerland. This is the final of the women's 4x200-meter freestyle relay. Four lengths of the pool for each of the swimmers, so that means 16 lengths in total. Several layers of intrigue to come in this race, and expect the leads to change just a little. But certainly the favorites for the gold will be swimming in lane 5, People's Republic of China. They have got a couple of World Aquatics Championships medalists. Japan touch ahead of USA, South Africa touch third. And that's over an opening 50. The changeovers need to be crisp, they need to be clean as well. If you leave this block too early, you will be disqualified. The reaction time needs to come after the swimmer in the pool has touched the wall, and then you can go. You can anticipate their touch, but you can't jump the gun, so to speak. The gun being the touch of the wall. China ahead of South Africa, ahead of USA, with Japan currently in fourth as Matsumoto goes into the pool for Japan. Japan coming back into it now as Matsumoto is making up ground on the swimmers around her. But it is South Africa who lead from China now. Erin Gallagher looks fantastic in the pool. She's a sub-2-minute swimmer, very comfortably over 200 freestyle. And she's proving her strength in the water here, having already swum in the pool this evening. She's looking to go a really quick time and under 2 minutes and have South Africa leading at the halfway mark. China are dropping further back with Jing in the water, but they've still got Zhang Yufei and Li Bingjie to come, so there's plenty of energy for China. South Africa first in the changeover. They lead by 1.5 seconds from Japan. China touch third, but do not worry about the positions at the moment. There's still 400 meters to go in the pool, but we're under the 4-minute mark at the 400 meter mark. 3:59.91 for South Africa as Georgia Nell goes in the pool, but she's already been caught by Zhang Yufei, who is up onto effectively her head. And Zhang Yufei might not get to the wall first, but China are completely in control of this race at the moment. 1/100th of a second separating China from South Africa. That lead has been decimated. Japan currently in third. And Zhang Yufei is showing her incredible ability as an all-round swimmer again. Zhang Yufei just ups the pace ever so slightly as she'll come towards the wall. And Li Bingjie will take over in the pool now. It's China ahead of USA, well on course for gold. Japan touch third ahead of South Africa. Paige McEachin is going to touch second, but Li leads by over 2 seconds, coming home in the final 50 into the 16th length of this pool. Plenty of drama in the early stages of this race. South Africa led at one stage, Japan led early, but China have controlled this race, not from start to finish, paced themselves particularly well, led off by Liu Yuxin, a 156 swimmer who went 157 to start. A second gold medal in the pool on the night for Li Bingjie, a fifth gold medal for Zhang Yufei as China win here. USA touch for a stellar silver, and Japan will beat South Africa to the wall and medal again tonight. China ahead of USA, ahead of Japan, South Africa touch fourth. Singapore and Switzerland still to come to the wall. In lane one, it'll be Singapore, 8:25.36 and 8:27.62 for Switzerland. But the champions go sub 8 minutes, China 7:58.77, and none of the swimmers exerted themselves. Japan with a very fine second. But Zhang Yufei, the smiling face of Zhang Yufei, the world champion in individual and relay events, helping China to another gold and claiming her fifth gold of Chengdu 2021 from 5 events. Li Bingjie with her fourth gold. Liu Yaxin with her fourth gold. Zhang Yufei with her fifth. And Jing Changbeihua watching on in the yellow swim cap, having claimed her gold in this 4x200-meter freestyle relay. People's Republic of China first, sub 8 minutes, USA second, and Japan third. Japan with a fine bronze, a stellar silver for USA, were brought right back in it by Mackie Hodges in the third leg. But People's Republic of China would not be denied a third gold medal on the night. They win gold in the 4x200-meter freestyle relay.